And you forget about modesty when it comes to getting changed. I mean, I'm whipping them off, and there's, you know, all sorts of goings on in the morning. I thought that's so weird, you know, but it was one of the hardest things to adjust to. But I tell you this, I confess all of this because it ties into some of these very brave shout-outs that we've been getting from our viewers about really embarrassing beauty things, you know, things like stretch marks and acne and dandruff, and, you know, they're things that are really embarrassing to talk about in public. And here to help us today with some of our shout-outs about delicate things, shall we say, is Michele Probst. She is a makeup artist to the stars. Hi, Michele.
Hi, girl.
I'm Rachel.
What a pleasure.
Nice to meet you. So, yeah, it's true, though, right? In this entire industry.
Girl, people don't know what you have to go through, and you look beautiful.
Well, thank you very much. Uh-huh. But, I mean, you have to just get over being modest of anything. You know
oh,
what
my
I mean?
Goodness.
So I think that you are the perfect person to tackle this. We're going to look at a tape from one of our viewers that has some bikini issues.
Y'all went on the street, huh?
We did. We did. We're brave like that. Okay, let's take a look at the first tape here.
Hey, Rachel, this is Jamie. Kind of asking this really embarrassing question. My friends and I have been talking about it, and they kind of put me up to asking you, but basically, we all, sometimes when we shave the bikini line, we get these embarrassing bumps. Want to know, can we prevent this in any way? Can you help us get rid of this, or make it never happen? We'd appreciate any help. Thanks.
Brave, brave girl. Standing on the streets of Manhattan and talking about her bumps. Yeah. I don't know that I can make them go away forever, but you could probably help.
What you want to do is you want to exfoliate first. That's the most important thing. Get your skin very clean, very smooth. And then what I do, there are different waxes on the market, whatever you need to do. This is one of my favorites, and you can microwave it, whatever you need to do.
But what's it called?
This is a zip, and you can get it at the drugstore. It's
right in the drugstore.
Right
cheap and cheerful.
I'm a drugstore girl.
I'm all about the drugstore.
So, yeah. and then if you do it afterwards, too, think of what you're doing. You're ripping, you're tearing the skin. So you want to do something cool, maybe aloe, any kind of gels or ointments that have all natural, all organic stuff in it.
And that'll cool you down.
Cool yeah. you down.
Aloe's also cheap and cheerful. You get it right
oh,
at the drugstore.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Don't shave it. Zip it.
Zip it.
Zip it.
Zip it off.
You know what makes me think of that really great scene in 40-Year-Old Virgin where they rip off
oh, gosh, yes.
The man-o-lantern?
Well, that's our next section.
Hysterical.
We're talking about that
Yeah,
later.
We're going to embarrass the guys, too. That'll be in a few minutes, so don't think you're safe. All right, next date.
Hey, Rachel, this is Tracy. I have a kind of embarrassing question to ask. What's a girl supposed to do about that nasty black hair that she gets on her upper lip? Waxing? Bleaching? What's the best way to get rid of it?
Well, let's just call it what it is. It's a mustache.
It is.
And unfortunately, as you age, and different people get it in different places, but hair grows on your face. And what you can do, again, you can do the wax thing, or you can go get it done professionally and get electrolysis. But y'all, how embarrassing. So if you do know this is an issue for you, get a good pair of tweezers. We have some up here. And what's important is don't get the little pointy ones. Get the one with the straight edge so you can really get a grip on it. And same thing for brows. I mean, I have clients that get it all over, but all of us women, we have to deal with this. It's not fair, but do it, rid of it.
Where's Diane? We have one in the audience here, a woman in the audience.
Oh, yeah.
Diane, you're beautiful. You remind me of Courtney Cox. Beautiful. Stand up. What is your embarrassing question?
My embarrassing question is, what do you do about that little bulge of fat that comes over your little muffin top?
Muffin tops, a very common problem.
Well, I call it love handles, but...
yeah. I like the way you said it. Love handles.
If that is, I can't see her, but if that is the only area that you're having an issue with, it's typically going to be something that you're eating or drinking, typically sugar-based. But honey, exercise. I mean, lots of water, toning. I mean, that's pretty much what it is.
Oh, there's no trick. There's no trick to it. You got to just do sit-ups.
Suck it up.
As I said, we are not going to let the guys off the hook. We are going to do embarrassing guy beauty tips after this.
You thought women had tough grooming issues. Wait till you hear what the dudes are dealing with.
Is there anything I can, you know, possibly do to kind of knock that off?
typically what happens is men that lose their hair on their head, it comes out of the places. So, but as far as like ears and nose and stuff, there are products out there. I mean, you can tweeze, but that's too obnoxious. And of course, I'm going to always say, if you want it permanent, electrolysis. But we actually have one of the tools here. This is, I call it like the mini weed eater, because you can just kind of go on up there and go on in here and go over here, and you're covered. For ear and nose, definitely a utensil is the best way to go.
Nobody's used this. We'll give you our weed whacker, okay? Next to Jimmy is Jason. Jason, what's your problem, buddy?
Okay, I go to the gym a lot. I play a lot of sports, and I sweat a lot. And I use every kind of antiperspirant, deodorant, and I still get these white, this yellow sweat stains on my white T-shirts, and they won't go away.
If it's the yellow stain, you know what that is? It's your deodorant, and it's the chemical in your deodorant. Because think about it, where else are you getting yellow stains? Nowhere else. So it's typically your deodorant. But what is important to do is, again, if you have a lot of sweat issues, drink a lot of water. You know, what you put in internally comes out externally. Mm-hmm. So think about that. But, you know, get a natural, again, organic products to use for deodorant, I think would help. Okay. But sweating is good, as long as it doesn't smell.
Right, but so it's the chemical additives that they're putting into some of the antiperspirants that cause the stain.
You've got your favorite white T-shirt, and after a couple of times, it does. You can get yellow stains under there, and it's the deodorants.
Yeah. But at least you know it's not you.
Yeah, you're not unique.
It ain't coming out of
you. You're not alone in that.
Ian, lucky number three here. What's your problem, buddy?
I'm a pretty manly man. I play a lot of sports.
We had no question, Ian.
I play a lot of sports, and come the summertime, I want to wear sandals out, but I can't because I have this one really embarrassing yellow toenail.
Ooh.
Help me out best you can.
Okay, well, you know, I think that we need to have a rule about summer and spring, and if you do have non-pedicured toes, no open-toe shoes, people, okay? Let's just make that rule.
Thank you.
Yeah. A manly man can go for a pedicure.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, guys, y'all, it feels good. You look good. It's 20 minutes, and it's inexpensive. You can go anywhere. But the natural resolve for that is EVOO. And what happens is...
That.
Do you love that? I knew you'd fit in. So, but what it is it's a fungus. And like you said, you're working out. Typically, you're going to get it from the gym, like a public gym, or, like a day spa kind of thing. So if the EVOO does not work, because it can actually get down into the second layer of your skin, it is a fungus. You can go... you know, call a derm or a podiatrist and get more help. But this is the starter.
This is fantastic.
Yes.
My mom uses it. Pedicures, hair treatment, whole thing. Who knew?
Who knew?
EVOO, it's good in the kitchen.
Yeah.
It's good on your toes.
All over your body.
It's all purpose. This is so much fun. I wish we had 500 more guys and girls questions.
Yes.
Up next, we are going to talk about, oh, this is going to be awesome. We're going to do a girl's guide to men. It's going to be so much fun. And will you please come back and we'll do some more of these next time?
Thank you, Rachel.
I love doing it. Call back. Be right back, guys.
Don't leave now, because we're about to give you an eye-opening look inside the world of men.
It takes a lot of getting to know a person to really believe that you can trust them.
I trust my wife. I do believe, in general, women will always try and get away with whatever they can get away with.
Closed captioning provided by...
Why use C-Bond when pre-cut Polygrip strips are easier to use and hold better? Polygrip strips beat C-Bond.
Disney's classic fairy tale continues with an all-new twist.
I am not going to let you get away with this.
Cinderella 3, A Twist in Time on Disney DVD February 6th.
Do you suffer from frequent migraine headaches? If so, you may be eligible to participate in a research study evaluating the effectiveness of an investigational medication for the treatment of headaches in adults with migraines. To qualify, you must be between the ages of 18 and 65 and experiencing headaches on at least 15 days each month. Participants will receive all study-related care and medication at no cost and may also be compensated for time and travel to the clinic. Health insurance is not needed to participate. Call now to see if you qualify. 1-800-474-8705.